loving your neighbor does not mean you as an individual alone will have to communicate it. You must have a kind of people who can share this burden with you. For example, if it's a Christian group and it's always meeting in your home and you are doing all the cooking, all the entertaining, why can't other Christians bear this? You must remember that loving your neighbor is not just accepting everything what the neighbor wants to say. That love also is expressed sometimes in correcting people, in speaking frankly to people, but at the same time lovingly, not condescendingly, not from a position of spiritual superiority or pride. And so we must learn to cultivate that kind of a transparent relationship. Sometimes loving your neighbor will also be refusing to help them so that they can learn to help themselves. Something that they are capable of doing, which they want you to do for them, you can surely refuse to do for them. That is also an expression of love. We think this love is all that cushy-cushy thing that we see in movies. No, no. Love is also means being strict and being strong, being firm, and at the same time being trustworthy and being open. And try to combine those things.